I got guys with me, I'll eat your f***ing eyes out of your head. And they're as loyal as a mother f***. And they got balls the size of cows. I would take them to mom and tell them, come on, load up, we're going to blow this whole f***ing joint. They'll walk in and blast everybody. With no hesitation or nothing, and don't look f***ing guys.
And you cannot come near me. Heard a fuck nigga wanna kill me. Cause I treat his baby mama like free. Fuck nigga, try again. You lose, I win. Shoot him in the ass, again. Pray for my enemies, amen. The realest nigga in it, amen. Shit, this young nigga popping, damn. Nah, can't no nigga stop him. Paper route, we stand on top of shit. Pull up in your city, we rockin' shit. I'm in the streets where the hitters at. I'm in the streets where the dealers at. I'm in the section where all the bad bitches at.
Keep the change, you filthy animal.
It's not about east or west. It's about power and money, riders and punks. Which side are you on?
Gun smoke.
It's gone. Spirit, lyrics like the Holy Quran.
Wowzers. Good evening, Mob Tube. I think I'm live. I think so. I don't know. Is this thing working? Son of a bitch. I don't know. Hold on. It is working. Shit. Anyway, what's up, guys? Damn, I wasn't supposed to curse. Damn it. Anyway, salute, Bob 2. How's it going? Just wanted to say hello to the people. It's been a while. It's been a while since I last saw you. Yeah. So I just wanted to say hello. I just dropped a new video that I put together. I don't know. Just felt like doing something new. And, I hope you guys like it. I'm going to play it now. I'm going to premiere it. I'm sure you guys have already seen it anyway, but since I just dropped it like half an hour ago, but might as well just watch it again, right? Why not, huh? It's good to see you guys in here, man. Let me just set this up and I'm going to say hello to everybody. Hold on, man. Yeah. Hold on. Yeah. Okay. All right, that'll work. Anyway, let me see who I got in here. Miss Can't Be Wrong was the first one in here. Look at this. Hi, how you doing? Good evening, Miss Can't Be Wrong. We got Bobby in here. Hey, yo. We got Sven from Denmark, my guy. Edward. We got Edward in here. We got my Luchin, Carlos. My Luchin. We got Gianni. What up, salute Gianni. That's my guy. We got Bobby. Bobby. Big Lou, my guy. Big Lou's in this motherfucker. Yeah. Oh, I got to start highlighting your comments, see? I'm a little rusty. It's been a while. It's been a couple weeks. I had to take a break from you mob tubers. I've been watching, though. Mob tubers. Oh, God. That's so lame. Mob tubers. Yeah, man. Going tube sledding, man. Yeah. Hello, people. Man, we're going tube sledding with the mob tubers. Happy holidays, folks. Oh, holidays are over. Man. Gunpoke Don is back. It's a new season, folks. Looks like he's been getting to work on his videos again, too. Oh, we got Joe Delamura in here and Yankees. What's up? Oh, my God. Angel Gotti's here, too? Why can't I see that? Where's my thing, man? Let me look at my phone. You guys are lying. Don't you lie to me. What's up, Big Lou? Dragon Reborn? Yeah. Oh, wow. Yeah, get rid of him, Miss Can't Be Wrong. That's right. Get rid of him. Yeah. Anyway, oh, Angel is here. Gotta show respect. Yeah, there you go. Made her a moderator. Yeah. I can always trust an angel. What up, son of Hawaii? What's going on? And welcome, Angel. Thank you for stopping by. I really appreciate you coming here. Thank you. That's what's up. Wow. That's awesome. I'm just reading your guys' comments right now on my phone because the stupid StreamYard doesn't keep up or something. I don't know. It's hiding comments or something. Like I watch Baywatch in here, but I don't see him on my StreamYard. Yeah, anyway, whatever. Anyway. I forgot how to use this damn thing. All right, here we go. Share screen, I guess. Oh, wait. No, remove. You see, you take a couple weeks off and you forget how to navigate this stuff. All right, hold on. Share system audio, yes. All right. That'll work. Why doesn't it look like it's working on my phone? Because it's not working. Is that why? Gun smoke. All right, something's messed up here. Oh, that's why. Is that why? No. Okay, guys, I'm sorry, man. Always unprepared as usual. You know, I should have just, instead of just rushing the show, I should have just planned it out better. Let me just talk to you guys for a minute here. So anyway, I was talking to a friend the other day, and he's like, what makes you believe that, you know, John Gotti was really there at the hit on Castellano? Why? Because Sammy said so? And I thought about it. I was like, well, actually, that's true. The only, you know, I never questioned it. I never thought about to question it. But, yeah, the only person who ever said he was there was Sammy the Bull. That's the only guy who puts him at the scene. And, you know, I feel like lately Sammy's been embellishing a little bit with his stories. And I don't know. Maybe he's lying about John being there. Why would John be there? I mean, it's a high-profile hit. It's a lot of risk. I mean, he wouldn't even show up to meet up with him to plot the murder, let alone sit in a car with him and witness it go down. So I thought that was an interesting topic to, you know, talk about with you guys, see what you guys thought about it, because I never even thought to question it, you know, but he's right. The person was right when they said it, you know. It's basically only his word. But, I thought, I was like, you know, let me do a video about that. I want to make a video, too, about it. But there was more stuff I was supposed to look at and include in the video. But it would have taken forever, man, just to try to find the stuff. Where Sammy, in his book, he said, you know, we didn't say anything in the car. We just listened to the radio. Then on the show, I can't find the episode, but he said, oh, wow, that was some big hit, huh, Sammy? You know, had a whole big conversation in the car. So I thought it was like a little inconsistency there. So maybe John really wasn't there at all to begin with. You know, who knows? he did lie on the Diane Sawyer interview years ago saying, I'm not a drug dealer. I never was a drug dealer. Why would I deal drugs? I don't like that type of business and deal with all those type of people. And then what was he doing as soon as he got into witness protection? He was fucking dealing dope in Arizona. So, that was one lie. Inconsistency, you could catch him in if you wanted to put it that way. I don't know why I get on here and I start talking different. When I talk to people on the phone, it's different. I get on here and it's like I try to act all polite with you people. Gotta be more myself and just feel like, you know, fuck it, you don't like me, whatever. But anyway. Let me try to figure this out. Hold on, because I really wanted to play this video. What's going on here? All right. Share screen. All right, let's see if that works. Still doesn't look like you're looking at my screen, right? Damn it, man. All right, let me take the comment off the screen and see if this is live. What the hell's going on here? I love you, Bob Tube. You guys are the best, by the way. What's up, Steve Tartola? Who else we got in here? Taylor Hill. What's up, Taylor Hill? What's going on? Yankees. Yankees for life. What's up? What's up? Oh, there's Angel. Now I see it on the stream yard. Yeah, get rid of all the bad turds out of here. The turd bird. The hell? What the hell is he saying? Yeah, get these idiots out of here. Look at these people. No wonder I took off a couple weeks to get away from these lowlifes. Oh, man. It's really pissing me off. I can't figure out the StreamYard here. Or maybe I'm just bugging. I don't know. Where is this? Yeah, I know. It's been a while, Taylor. I can't believe I'm having technical difficulties over here. How about that? Does that work? What's going on here? There's a disconnect here, man. Nah, StreamYard is bugging because that should work. I don't know why that doesn't work. It's not showing up. All right, that's wonderful. Just lovely. That puts a wrench in my freaking plans. All right, well, I guess we're just going to talk about the video then since I can't show it. Damn it! All right, let me just read what you guys are saying. Oh, the Canadian truckers up there. Yeah, they got $10 million to Canadian truckers up there. And who's holding it? Who's holding the fund? GoFundMe is holding the funds back, holding that money hostage because they don't want to give it to them. They're building up a political movement up there that's more powerful than the government up there. They made more money than any political party up there. That's crazy. I'll take the overlay off screen and then play over. Oh, that's why I got an overlay on. Do I? Hold on. Okay. Yeah. Brand. Okay. Nice. Okay. Thank you, FBS. FBS to the rescue. Look at that. Smart guy. Okay. Okay, now I'm confused again. Okay, here we go. Hold on. I gotta set this thing up all over again. Thank you, FBS. I really appreciate that. I would have been here like a stunad the whole time. Like, what the hell? Dirt. All right. You're the best. That's what friends are for. All right. There we go. Yeah. There we go. Breathwork.
Gone. You are watching a master at work.
John Cotty, clipped, assault you, my Duchene, without my okay. That's a flagrant violation. John Cotty, you fucking die.
I'm gonna tell you something. If you two never bottled me again the rest of my life, I ain't giving them anything. If you never bottled me again the rest of my life, I can't. There's good friends of mine on the fucking thing. It was some fucking asshole like Marty or somebody like that. I give them 3 seconds flat. They're good guys on the fucking stage.
This is going to be a closing motion for tonight's night. An hour from now, it'll be tonight, or 100 years from now, when it's going to be a
Los Anos. From here on out, anyone here might call a fuck for your action. You just come to me.
Who the fuck are you?
John Daddy.
DB said, Angelo Ruggiero wants to see you. Could you take a ride out to Queens? And he gave me the time. I said, yeah, I'll go there. I got in the car and I drove out there. I saw Angelo on the corner. I pulled over, I parked the car, I got out. I walked to him, hey, Ange, how's everything going? I already knew about his problems. How's everything going? Okay, Sammy, he says, I need to ask you for a tremendous favor. Whatever I could do for you, bro. What? What do you want me to do? I need you to help me. We're going to kill the boss. You're going to what? We're going to kill the boss. Who? Who's going to do it? You? Me, John Gotti. I don't see John Gotti. I just see you. Where's John Gotti? Well, you know, Sammy, he's doing something and, you know, I don't know nothing, bro. You're asking me to kill a fucking boss and I got to know, you don't even have an answer for him where the fuck he is. In other words, is he asking me to kill the boss too? Of course, we're together. Then why ain't he here? What is this, just some bullshit message? Could you pick me up a container of milk? You're talking to me about killing the boss. Listen, Angelo, I don't want to talk about it. We met them downtown, away from Sparks that afternoon. I met with all of them. They had these white coats on, Russian hats. These look great. It's a perfect color. We left, me and John. And we went half a block away from Sparks, sitting in a car. Five, 5:30. They're not here yet. Something's wrong. I'm talking to John. I'm on the passenger side. I'm coaching the guys who are on the team. There's 11 guys, I believe, on there. And I'm talking to them. Stay calm. Relax. They're not here yet, but relax. The light turns green. They start to pull through the light. I tell the team, the light just turned green. The first car out is them. Get ready. The shooters are ready. The backup teams are ready. The backup shooters are ready. I'm ready. My heart is pounding. I told John, pull up. Pull right past them and go real slow. The windows were tinted. I put the window down about an inch and a half. Put myself at top and looked down. Tommy Bilotti was blown away, laying in the middle of the street. Paul was on the sidewalk, laying half in the street and half on the sidewalk. He was down. I couldn't see him. The car blocked. What do you think? Tommy's dead. I'm sure he's dead too. Pull out. We pulled out and we went to the corner. We made a right-hand turn. I turned on the radio. News 88 was blaring out. There was a major organized crime hit in Manhattan, mentioning the street, mentioning things. I looked at John, I said, this hit is not even 3-4 minutes old. How is that possible that this is on the fucking news? John, I don't know. Put on 1010 wins. I put on 1010 wins. It wasn't only on the news, it said, the boss of all bosses, Paul Castellano, has been rubbed out gangland style in front of Sparks Steakhouse. I says, it's not only on the fucking news. They might as well tell our names. They know exactly where the fuck it was. How is this possible? If you gave me $1 million right now and you said, how did you get home? The bridge, the tunnel, I don't have a fucking clue. I really don't. I was so focused on the hit, the radio, and talking to John. I don't even know how we got back into Bensonhurst, Brooklyn. He was going to my office where I was going to meet Frank and Chico. That's the meeting spot. And then we were going to go back. John was supposed to go on a duck with his guys and bunk in with his guys. The war is on.
Just like my love.
change, you filthy animal.
You mean the Ruggiero thing?
What Tom Gotti problem? What problem? Don't you guys fucking read? Give me that newspaper. When the New York Times carries it, you got trouble. And then last week with this chicken guy, what's his name? Looks like a chicken. What the hell's he gonna think when he sees these headlines?
Come on, Paul. These guys are not stupid. They know who we are.
But it's not supposed to be so public. But what the hell is it with these $3,000 suits? I mean, the man dresses better than Cuomo. And these FBI bugs. Who knows what's on those fucking tapes? Do you? Who the hell knows what kind of shit that fat fuck Angie talked about me?
Forget about it. I said a lot of shit about people about Paul too.
If those tapes show that Angie knows two other mamalukes are dealing powder, well, the rule is since 1957, deal and die. I gotta clip him. And Johnny Boy too.
Yeah, that part. That part, homie. That part. Yeah, that was cool. I hope you guys liked that. Thank you, guys. All right. Hold on. Let me see the comments. 90 comments. Jesus. What's going on, people? So, yeah. Can't get that song out of my head now. And the B goes, oh. Sammy remembers a lot of stuff from back in the day. Sammy loves to tell stories, but he can't remember how he got home after, you know, the hit. He doesn't remember if he took the tunnel or the bridge. Come on, man. What you mean you don't remember? What you mean you don't remember how you got home, man? But you remember everything else, though, right? That part, homie. That part. Something's not right, man. Something's not right. Story don't add up. What you mean you don't remember if you took the tunnel or the bridge home? What are you talking about? You remember everything else, though? I don't know. Maybe he was so shocked by the trauma of the crime that he just blacked it out of his mind. I don't know. Who knows? But these things happen. Oh, thank you, Sven. Thank you. Thank you, Gianni. Yeah. Brioni suits. Brioni suits. Yeah. And he got a haircut every day. I heard that was true. Yeah. Thank you, Miss. Thank you, Carlos. Thank you, my friend. You're the best. Yeah. Sammy tells a good story, you know? Tells a really good story. But who knows if it's true? I need another eyewitness to say, yeah, I saw him there. He was there. Yeah. John was there. I don't know. I never pondered it until the other day, until about 2 days ago. Never crossed my mind that, wait a minute, he's the only one that ever said that he was there. Why should we believe? I thought it'd be an interesting topic to talk about with you guys. Let's see what you guys are saying. You guys don't have any questions or answers, huh? You motherfuckers. Let's see what this guy said. Okay, here, it's something good, yeah. I can't imagine being a Bellotti or a Castellano relative and seeing my family members' autopsy photos online with bullet holes in his face. Yeah, I know. It's horrible. I'm sorry. You're right about that. You're right about that. These things happen. They did it to Tupac. They did it to King Von. They did it to a lot of people. I think they did it to Selena. They did it to Princess Diana, I think. Who else did they do it to? A whole lot of people. It's not right. I don't know why the coroner does that. But it's the way of the world. Look, when they killed Uday and Kuse in 2003 during the Iraq War, they put them on the front page, their dead bodies on the slab. Front page news. They used to do it back in the day in the 30s. Whenever they killed a gangster or whatever, they used to parade the whole town. Used to come into the city morgue and walk past the body and stuff. and take pictures, sick bastards. It's a sick world out there. What do you want me to do about it? I just put the pictures up there for shock value because I know that's what you guys want to see. The guts and gore, you sick bastards. That's what the mafia genre is, right? That's the sad reality of it. I'm trying to show you the sad, harsh reality of the freaking mafia genre. It's not pretty. It's not pretty. It's a lot of glitz and glamour, a lot of fun, but then there's a lot of harsh realities. Creep up on your ass, boy. You wake up one day, you don't wake up tomorrow, motherfucker. But yeah. Yeah, that part, homie. That part. Say, what's up with it, man? Yeah. Oh, is that what he was saying? Look at this guy, Edward Everett. Imitate Lee, Gunsmoke. Hello, people. I don't know. I don't even want to talk about that piece of shit anymore. I've been so out of it for the past few weeks. I don't even want to talk about that fucking little life. Let's see what Carlos has to say. John J. Gotti was an intelligent man and knows it wouldn't be wise to hang out at the scene of the crime. Yeah, I'm thinking that too. Why would he put himself there? If his ego was so big that he wouldn't even talk to Sammy to even plot the murder, why would he put himself at the murder scene to witness it and be, you know, at risk of being seen by a police officer, by anybody? And he's already a known face by that time. They know, you know, who he is. He got even more famous after the hit, but it's not like he was a nobody. So it's not a good look for him to be sitting on the corner of a friggin' murder, double homicide as it's going down. I don't know. Could be, but, you know, there's a possibility, of course, but it's a good chance that he wasn't there and that the story's bullshit. And if he's not there, then maybe Sammy's not there. And if Sammy's not there, then the whole story's bullshit. I don't know, man. I don't know. It's a whole conundrum, you know? Yeah. What the hell's this? Yo, what up? What up, bro? What's going on? Can't even read that name. MLG swag, boy. Oh, okay. What you know about networks? What you know about networking, miss? Talk about networks. What you know about networking? I don't know nothing about it. People used to gather at hangings. Yes, that's true. Yeah. It's another sad reality. This country's crazy, man. I don't know if a senior to say that he puts it on his kid, I'd have to say I would believe John is telling the truth. Yeah. That part, homie. That part. What you know about that? What you know about that? We got Duck Fart here. Duck Fart, what up? Salute. What's going on, Duck Fart? We got DP over here. Can you please bring another funny video like back in the early MobTube Gunsmoke era? The early MobTube Gunsmoke era. Wow, I like that. Hold on, homie. Hold on. I gotta hit invite, click copy ball. Go drop that motherfucker right there, like bang. Listen, just don't go off breaking my balls now, all right? If I was gonna break your balls, I'd tell you to go home and get your shine box. Shouts to Shinebox, too. I miss Shinebox. I haven't seen him around. Shouts to my guy, Shinebox. Yeah. The king of MobTube said, drop the Lizink. Look at this guy. Schmeagel said he was there, but couldn't identify all the shooters for someone who plotted it. What do you mean he couldn't identify all the shooters? What the fuck? Uh-oh, here we go.
Hello. What's up, you filthy animal?
What's going on, man? Is that a brown?
What?
Is that shirt brown?
No, it's like burgundy, maroon, I don't know.
Brown. I used to wear brown back in the day, yeah.
Fuck, bro.
Yeah, I'm just saying, what up, what up, what up?
Why are you putting out false information about the color of my shirt in front of all these people?
That's how we do it on Mob 2, man. We make accusations and we stick with it.
Even if you know they're false?
Exactly. That's how we do it.
So what's going on? Listen.
Yeah.
There's no way John Gotti was at the scene of that hit.
100%. I'll give it a good 70% he was there. 30% he was not there.
Listen, I don't know. I mean, we'll never know, I guess. But he was already a well-known figure in New York.
Yeah.
Angel even said the other day that she saw a video of her father dressed in all black in a video in 1979. After the Favara thing, he was all over the news. The media was all over him. It's not like he didn't become, it's not like he became a known figure only after the Castellano hit. He would have had to be out of his fucking mind to go to that hit on a busy street in Manhattan, Christmas time, the biggest hit to take place in a long, long time, and be seen, take the chance of being seen.
Yeah.
If he would have been seen, he would have been fried right there.
The exactly. Yeah. I'm sure so he was on probation or parole at that time, too, or some shit like that. Had to be, right?
No, nah, not at that time. Nah, he hadn't been in prison for a while.
Okay.
No. Nah. But why put yourself there? Like you said a minute ago, he didn't even want to go to Sammy. He sent Frank DeChico and Quack Quack to talk to Sammy about doing this. So yeah. Why would he show up at the hit? That's insane. Guys that are in that position at that point, they don't show up to murders, especially not that
much. It's unnecessary, though. It's not like he needs to be there for anything. You know, why would he be there? For what?
Exactly.
Except for his own entertainment. But would he be that type of person to want to do that?
It would do nothing but put him at risk.
Exactly. It's going to do nothing good for him.
Yeah, there'd be no point. So why do that?
Sammy maybe to supervise the hit, okay. But now I'm hearing that maybe Sammy wasn't even there either.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know, bro. I just I know that the government needed Sammy to put John Gotti at the scene of that hit.
Yeah.
And what better way than to say I was with him? Not that, oh, I heard he was there, this or that. No. Make it, you know, rock solid and say I was there. He drove me or I drove him or whatever. And we were in the car together. We witnessed the whole thing. We drove by slowly and looked at the bodies, which just even that, when you add that to it, it makes it all the more absurd. Why would you do that, bro? I'm just a regular guy, and if I'm involved in a murder, I'm not driving past it slow with a street full of witnesses so they can look over and see my face and say, hey, I've seen that guy in the news. That's John Gotti.
Another thing Sammy likes to say, too, for some reason, he acts like it's a bad thing. Like, oh, John Gotti was my driver. He was my driver that night. Like, oh, that's like, I don't know, like a lesser role or some shit. I don't know. Like he's like being chauffeured around by John Gotti and shit. What the fuck are you looking at, boy? What the fuck are you checking your beeper and shit?
I'm putting something together for you.
Oh, nice. Okay, nice. He's trying to save my life.
I'm planning a hit.
Nice.
Just kidding. Just kidding. Yeah. We're being watched and listened to. So just kidding.
Nobody's watching this. I got 30 people here if I'm lucky. Not even. No one's watching this.
Well, let's see. What else we got? Let me look at some comments. Look, I'm doing the same thing I do.
Yeah, I know. I got to say what up to Joey Knuckles. Thank you. $5.
I'm fidgeting with the fucking mouse. You know what I mean? I sent you a Cash App.
You yeah, you did. Thank you. Thank you so much for the Cash App. Thank you.
It wasn't much. Thank you. It's a little something.
No, it's definitely needed. Thank you. And Octavia says something nice in here, too. I know she's one of Tony's good
girls. I haven't seen her in a while. Somebody was asking about her last night.
She said, hi, Gunsmoke. I don't know you, but Tony very much regretted contacting your granddad. I hope you and your family are well. Best of luck in your new channel. Good for you. Shinebox is a dope.
Yeah, Tony at least, listen, what he did was fucked up, but he at least apologized.
Yeah, which is very nice of him. Yeah.
Yeah, it's more than a lot of these fucking jerk offs on here will do.
That's true. So that is a good point.
Yep. Yeah, so bro, I don't know, man. I'll just never believe it. The more I think about it, the more I'm like, it doesn't make sense. Why would John Gotti, under what circumstances would he think it's a good idea to put himself at the scene of such a fucking high profile murder?
Yeah.
And you know, Sammy's story has changed. There was another story that two witnesses had said that they had seen John Gotti on the corner when it happened, but no Gravano. So there's been different stories.
Somebody said, oh, Sammy's story has always been the same. It never changed. Somebody said that earlier. Or he might have left a comment on my video about it.
Well, but he said at one point that they talked about it on the way home, right?
Yeah.
And then at another point said that they didn't say a word to each other.
Yeah, in his book he said he can't remember saying anything to John. They just listened to the radio and that was it. They didn't say nothing to each other. And then on his show, he's saying, oh, we had this conversation. I'm still looking for that video. So I remember seeing it. It's just so many videos to look through. He puts out a lot of content. So and I kind of rushed this video.
Well,
anyway.
Sammy's stories have a way of evolving and changing over time.
Definitely on his show, he definitely embellishes the stories now. And like the conversations and stuff.
Yep. DP says, no, I'm saying if they weren't there, then why does Sammy tell the story so vividly and describe them there in the car and saw Paul and Bilotti drive by? I know what you're saying, but listen to A-Light, how vividly he tells stories. If you practice it enough over and over in your head, and it's a pretty simple story. You know what I mean? It's not hard to remember. And he spent, 17 years in prison? No problem reciting it over and over in his head after he said it on the stand.
Yeah.
You know, man. I mean, anything's possible. It's just my opinion. And Gunsmoke seems to feel the same way.
I do, yeah.
It doesn't make sense. Captains and stuff, they insulate themselves from those things. They don't put themselves near murders. No less that
much. One of the perks, yeah.
Oh, FBS was responding to Miss Campy Rome. My bad. I think I'm in charge sometimes when I'm on somebody else's show.
Yeah, so please. I'm a little rusty right now, so I need all the help I could get back in the swing of things. It's my Octavia, first live.
No, it's all good, bro. I'm here to help you out. Octavia said, love to Shannon as always. Yes, my heart. Been a bit sore. It's okay. Good luck, guys. I'll check in again. Good on you, Gunsmoke. Thank you, Miss Camp. Your heart, what's wrong, Octavia? Sorry to hear that. I don't know if you mean... I don't know. I don't know how you mean that. You know what I mean, Gunsmoke?
Yeah.
No, you don't.
I'm reading it right now. I'm trying to.
You don't know what I mean because I don't know what I mean.
My heart been a bit sore.
I don't know if she means emotionally or.
Probably emotionally.
You know what I mean?
Probably emotionally. But anyway.
I know that I was just eating.
Oh my God. Is this really happening? We got a special guest here. Hello. Angel?
Hello.
Wow, it's the real Angel. How are you?
How are you?
I'm doing great now. What's going on?
I didn't watch what you played because
you don't want to. Yeah, you don't want to see that.
No. Plus, I was eating dinner with my daughter, so yeah. I missed it. We were listening to it. And then my daughter said, is that guy trying to be a DJ? What is that music coming?
I was briefly a DJ for like a few months.
I said he was a DJ, or I think he is a DJ. Look, I can't help it. I got the mouse in my hand trying to click on the comment.
I'm doing the same thing.
I do that sometimes, yeah.
I came on because... FBS said, why don't you go on?
Yeah, I know.
That's awesome.
To add to
because I'm going to tell you what in my brother's book, it says that my father said that my brother should rot in hell if Gravano was ever there.
That's so harsh, too, but yeah.
And my father would never, ever, ever say something like that. Never. You heard the card I read tonight that he wrote to me. At the end, he said, and I know you won't forget your brother, Frankie, meaning what that meant was, oh, wait, hold on. Stop, Vic, give them a treat so they won't bark. What that meant was, in other words, he knew that none of us would ever forget going to the cemetery.
Yes.
Like, in other words, he knew we were going to go to the cemetery for Christmas for my brother.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah. There's no way in the world my father would have ever said something like that if it wasn't true.
Exactly. Yeah. Especially the impact that, Frankie's passing had on your family,
Exactly.
It sounds like a very harsh statement. So, he means it when he says it.
Exactly. So he's a liar. Listen, there's a few projects in the works, and let's see what happens. I keep saying it over and over again. Gravano's not getting the last word. He's not.
He's been saying a lot lately, too. Excuse me. I smoke too much. But I saw what he said about your mom the other day on one of his videos.
Oh, hold on.
Did you see that FBS?
Yeah, bro. Disgraceful. And then
can you imagine what he was saying?
Oh, my God. What a fucking prick. Yeah. And then I was listening tonight to what he had to say, I guess, yesterday when he was talking about the other members of the Gotti family.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm going to be talking about this later on.
Oh, I'm back. My dog is Star Trek was on, and there was a hairy creature. So she barks at that. She barks at the TV. She watches TV. I never saw a dog in my entire life watch TV.
That's cute.
Yeah. Nice. But what were you saying now?
Well, Sammy released a video, I don't know how, maybe like a week ago, talking about your mom. And
I heard about it. I heard from, I think, FBS. I was watching him and I heard about it. Listen, I could say it over and over and over again. Say what you want, but none of the women in my entire family have a mugshot, unlike his family.
So, that's so true. Yeah.
You want to talk about my mother? Look at your wife and your own daughter. So, hey, none of us have mugshots. And I have a huge family.
Yeah.
Nobody has a mugshot. No women.
Well, there you go. It says a lot.
Yeah.
Considering Sammy's situation. And those mugshots are owed to him, too.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Exactly. So, what am I going to say? He wants to talk about my mother. My mother lost a child. She didn't sell drugs. Sorry.
But what's the purpose? Like, why would he do that? I don't get it. Like, the things he was saying, it's like, why is this video necessary? Like, to even bring it up. She has nothing to do with anything.
Yeah, I didn't see it. I don't want to see it. I don't watch him. Yeah. The only way I know anything that he says is when, all of you, everybody else says it. And I'll just keep saying that over and over again. He can't afford to talk about anybody in my family when all the men in my family, they went to prison and did their time.
Exactly. Yeah.
They didn't become rats and they didn't drag their, the women in their families into a drug dealing business and have mugshots. That's it.
The way he talks sometimes, it's like he never ratted. Like the way he speaks, it's like he's so oblivious to what he said.
Exactly. Exactly.
Yeah, I listened. Did you hear what he said tonight, Angel? Or I guess he said it yesterday. Did you listen to that?
No, I don't listen. I was waiting. I was going to wait for you. I thought you were going to do it tonight.
Oh, I am. I am. Right. Yeah, talks about, your uncles and stuff. And it's just like what Gunsmoke said. I don't know what end game he has here, but, he was basically bashing everybody, your uncle, Peter especially.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, he was saying some terrible things.
Yeah, but my Uncle Pete died in prison.
Yeah.
My Uncle Pete died in prison, and he was sick. He was really sick. He was blind in one eye. He had, I can't think right now. He had thyroid cancer. You name it.
Yeah.
he was sick and he still did his time.
Yeah, he did.
Yeah. That's what I was thinking when I listened to it. I'm like, wait a minute, you're calling this one an idiot, this one an imbecile, but they were all stand-up guys, no matter what you can say. There's yet to be one that flipped and did what you did. So,
yeah. You know, he's talking about tough guys, this and that.
Yeah, is it an insecurity thing? Like you're putting them down because you...
It's like a competition to him, I guess. I don't know.
Yeah, you know you're a lying rat bastard, so you're going to talk about stand-up guys like as if they're beneath you somehow?
I don't think he could eat it, man. He just can't live with it, I guess. He can't eat it.
He's... You know what it is? If when Michael Franzese announced, he tweeted something about Witsec Mafia, and Gravano lost it.
Yeah.
So that tells me he's worried about what's... Stop. He's worried about Witsec Mafia.
Oh, yeah.
That's the least of his worries.
That's so good to hear.
Yep.
Yeah.
I can't wait till Witsec Mafia comes out.
Yeah. I can't...
I know. Wait. I've been waiting for a while. Yeah.
I can't wait till it all comes out.
Yeah, yeah. That's going to be good. But that's what I feel like he's doing, Angel. You think maybe he's trying to, like it's a preemptive strike? Let me try to discredit everybody in the Gotti family before these things come out?
There's no way you can discredit. First of all, you got a second chance. You walked away after serving nothing for 19 admitted murders.
Yeah.
You got to... Witsec Mafia is about cooperators who, after cooperating with the government, go out and commit more crimes. That's what Witsec Mafia is about.
Yeah.
You know, so how are you going to deny that you did that? You did that.
Yeah.
Yeah, whatever. Yeah, whatever. So what are you going to discredit? You did do that. And, you know, the other... the other projects, we'll see. We'll see. Mm-hmm. You know, you can only, you can get on the internet and you can say whatever you want, but when there's proof, you know, he doesn't show any proof. It's just his word, you know, his word of mouth, you know, his word. So when you get up and you show proof, well.
Yeah.
We'll see what happens. That's all I'm going to say. We'll see what happens. You see how he tries to make everybody think that there's only Gotti tapes?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
He will not admit that there's Gravano Gotti tapes.
Yeah. There's Arizona tapes, too.
And, oh, yeah. Besides all of that. Yeah. There's Arizona tapes, too. Yeah. But listen, he can talk now. Let's see what happens.
How crazy is it, Angel? Like sometimes I sit back and I think about these things, and we've heard the story, so it's like, you know, it doesn't seem like a big deal to us. But when you really think about what happened with the timeline, this guy killed 19 people. Mm-hmm. He got off with 5 years. Gas pipe flips. Gas pipe tells the feds, listen, no, Sammy lied. He was a big drug dealer. He was a customer of mine. I'm under the belief that they tore up Gas Pipe's cooperation agreement because of that, because it could have possibly gotten your father a new trial. And then a few years later, Sammy gets caught running a huge ecstasy ring and proves that Sammy most likely was a drug dealer even back then.
Yeah,
you know what I mean? Like, it's so crazy to think about. He threw it in the faces of the government. He made them look foolish. You know, he made the whole witness protection program and everything else look bad. It's just, it's so crazy when you think about it.
Yeah. And how about, you know, when you, I mean, I know of this only because of the five trials, the four trials. When you become a cooperator and you cooperate with the government, if you lie on the stand, or if you commit crimes, your cooperation agreement gets ripped up and you're going to do the time that you were supposed to do. So they never did that with him, even though he got caught, you know, what he did. They still didn't charge him for all those murders. They didn't charge him for it. So he actually really just got charged for what he was doing, drug dealing in Arizona.
Yeah. I think was it Gaspipe who tried to connect him to killing that court officer in like 1981 as well? Or was that
Iceman?
That was Iceman?
Yeah. I don't know. I don't know any of that.
Yeah. I think his last name was Plate or something like that.
I'm not sure.
I don't know.
It was a big scandal. But yeah.
Yeah, I don't know. I know that I think that somebody died. Somebody conveniently died before they could charge him with anything.
Yeah.
Oh, you mean talking about Iceman dying before?
Right.
That is crazy, right? He really did.
Yeah.
It was like the day before or something, right?
That he was Yeah, I don't know. I just remember he died, and there was a lot of things that that could have come out at that trial, but my father wouldn't allow it to.
Uh-huh.
So, I mean, really bad things. but my father wouldn't allow it because he said, like I said 100 times, he said there's only one rat here.
Yeah.
And that was Gravano, not him.
So he wouldn't even let things come out that could have helped him.
Exactly.
Wow.
I can't remember right now if I played that before. Now I don't know what I played. I played two of them before, and I can't remember if one of them was that. Every time I get on here, I could never remember anything.
I'm the same way.
Yeah, that's so weird.
Yeah. Well, I can never remember anything as it is in general, but, you know.
Yeah, lately I'm pointing that out.
Yeah.
Oh, Yankees for life. You're funny. Yeah, you know what? My chicken wings, I thought, were a little too crispy. And meanwhile, my daughter loved them.
FBS had chicken wings tonight, too, didn't she?
Oh, you did?
Yeah.
So I made mine. And actually, as I'm sitting here, I'm watching smoke in the kitchen fill up the kitchen. I'm like, oh, why do I see smoke? Meanwhile, my chicken, there's something wrong with me lately.
Yeah, yeah, I think I'm pretty sure that I broke my tooth again on those wings.
Oh my god!
Oh, really? I hate that.
Yeah, I'm having an issue, man, with this root. I know that temporary filling they put in came out, so you know, it's always
that sad. Always happens. That always happens. What was I going to say? I was going to ask you something. Now I can't remember.
Was it about Sammy?
No, I never asked about. I can't remember.
Yeah, I don't know.
Yeah. But, oh, man. I can't remember.
Well, hopefully it'll come to you.
Yeah.
But yeah, I you know, me and Gunsmoke were having this conversation a few nights ago, and I'm like, why don't you do a show on this? Because I don't know. I mean, just the fact that it's so convenient. Sammy had to put your father at the scene, you know what I mean?
It never entered my mind to even question the narrative, you know? Like, I never even thought to question the story.
Well, yeah, we know the story so well that we never take a minute to sit back and say, wait a minute, where did the story come from?
It's him.
The one and only source.
Yeah.
Exactly. Him.
Yeah.
Exactly. But like I said, we'll see what happens.
Yeah.
You know, we'll see what happens.
I just want to point out that after I said that I broke my tooth, Carlos Munoz said, FBS, I would give you one of mine if I had it.
Oh, I can't.
Oh, my God.
Oh, I can't believe it.
I love that guy, man.
Wow. Carlos is great. Look at that. I can't believe that.
Yeah.
Man. So, Angel, you didn't watch The Last Gangster yet, right? You're not going to.
No, I'm not watching that.
I figured.
No, I have no desire to watch it. I don't want to watch him.
Did you see the A-Light locked up abroad? Locked up a fraud?
Yeah, that I saw. Locked up a fraud. That I saw. But listen, when at first I didn't want to watch it. And then I forgot who it was saying, no, you have to watch it. You have to watch it. And then I said, because I think I saw somebody said something about him crying. I said, okay. So I put it on and I'm sitting there in total shock. And then I just started laughing. I call Chris Casparosa. I tell him, you have to put it on. No, I'm not watching it. No. I'm telling you, you have to put this on. And I started laughing. I said, I'm telling you, he does the best fake man cry I ever saw in my life. You have to put this on. And he did. And we were both cracking up. Laughing so hard. I've never seen a human being that was so shameless in my whole life. Shameless to even do that. He lied so much on there. It was like, wait, what? Wait.
Yeah, it's ridiculous.
But then when he did that fake man cry, that was the best.
Yeah. I couldn't believe he did that. Yeah. And like, he wanted to laugh too. He knew he wanted to laugh, but I'm sorry. Go on, FBS.
No, I just wanted to say that whole episode is one of the most ridiculous things I ever saw.
Yeah, it was ridiculous.
The part where your father basically makes him in a private ceremony.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
To swear his honor and all.
Had a conversation with my father. Never had a conversation with my father. No, but you know what? Because then I got mad because I said, all these years I've been watching that show. How many of those stories were fake now? They don't even vet anyone. So those stories were fake. Yeah. How many of them?
Angel, I'm not lying when I tell you that was one of my favorite shows. I love that show. I can't watch it anymore.
I'm very disappointed in that, Gio, actually.
Yeah, yeah. My mother too. Like, we still love watching that show. Now you can't even believe anything that was ever on
it. It stains their reputation. Yeah.
Exactly. Now I know, like, oh man, you never even vetted any of all these years. You probably never vetted anyone. And we're idiots that believed it.
Hey, FBS, did A-Light really say that John Gotti took him to Carvel to get a cookie puss? Is that true?
No. Okay. That was the.
He said something to that effect, though, right? Like he got in the back seat, something like that. No,
I don't know. He might have, like, but I know right, that guy that's calling me. That's what he said as A-Light. That was hilarious.
Oh,
yeah.
Did he really say something about my father made him French toast?
Oh yes.
Yeah. No, he did not.
I believe so. No. I think that might have been an exaggeration by a commenter. But okay. He did say that he would sleep on the couch and stuff like that, and your father would come downstairs and, you know, some other horse shit. Yeah. The French horse thing might have been a commenter gone wild. I'm not sure.
Never, ever, 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 ever.
Could you picture
never
John Gotti?
Coming down the stairs.
You picture your father making A-Light French toast, Angel?
Yeah, no.
Did he even make you French toast?
No.
I don't picture your father being a cook.
No. Not at all.
Yeah, it's
what
insanity.
What a sicko.
I know.
I can't listen. I'm waiting so patiently. First, I'm waiting so patiently for my nephew's fight. I want to burst at the seams. But more than that, I'm waiting for the other things to come out. I can't wait. I just can't wait.
Let me ask you.
Everything always takes so long because everything has to be done right. It has to be done really right. Otherwise, you know, then... You lie about one thing, you're done.
Yeah.
You know, you're done. You even get something wrong, you're done. When you're in my family.
Yeah. So when do you think WinSec is coming out? Like in springtime?
I'm not sure about WinSec yet.
Yeah.
I'm just waiting on the other one first. I don't even care about WinSec, really. Yeah. Like, I really don't care about it.
Okay.
I'm waiting for the other thing, and that should be soon.
Nice. Let me ask you, in your opinion, who's worse in your eyes, Sammy or A-Light? Who's a bigger lowlife to you?
Well, see, I don't watch Gravano, so I don't know, like, what he says. And I only know what A-Light's been doing because he did it all on social media, you know. So A-Light also, you know, went after our kids, yeah. Went after, you know, went after the women, the kids. So I don't know. I don't think Gravano's done anything like that except for last week with my mother.
Yeah. But
I don't know. I really couldn't tell you. To okay. me, the biggest lowlife is a tie between the degenerate and A-Light. I don't know about Gravano.
The degenerate.
Yeah, I'd rather not say his name.
The degenerate. I got a thing.
Yeah, the degenerate who put my face on porn.
Okay.
So it's a toss up between those two, A-Light and his crew.
Well, they're hooked up together, so
yeah,
they're on the same team, yeah.
Yeah, exactly. But I don't know about Gravano, truthfully. I don't know the stories that he's telling. I don't know because I don't watch him.
Yeah.
Well, okay.
So
I that's a hard one. Like,
yeah, like I don't know my father's business. Like, I really don't know any of that. I don't follow it. I don't watch it.
Yeah.
I only know what's true and what's not true because I watched, you know, my brother's four trials, the racketeering trials, and then I saw, you know, I saw them like destroy A-Light on the stand. So that's how I know what's true, what's not true.
Uh-huh.
But with Gravano, I just don't know. But I'm sure we'll all find out soon.
Okay.
Like what's true and what wasn't true. We will definitely find out.
Yeah.
I can't wait.
Yeah, you and me both. I can't wait.
Yeah, I don't know. It's funny to me that Sammy, I mean, obviously, I guess, you know, he's always been bullshitting about, you know, your father basically forcing him into doing what he was doing and all that. But he's like the new A-Light now. Every fucking show that he does, excuse my language, he's talking about your father now. And now the other men in your family, your mother, like, what does he have to gain from bashing your mother and your uncles?
Yeah, I didn't understand that. I was like, what the hell is this?
See, now that's the difference between one of the many differences between Gravano and my family, because my family would never go after the women in his family, you know. So he had to go after my mother, whatever. My mother never liked him anyway. Yeah. She never liked him. And you want to say that she's crazy because she lost the child?
Exactly. You know?
I mean, she lost the child. What was she supposed to be like?
He said he couldn't empathize with her. He was trying to empathize and he couldn't or whatever. Something like that.
And he couldn't? Well, because he couldn't empathize with her because she didn't deal drugs. You know, she never dealt drugs and got arrested and has a rap sheet.
Yeah.
You know, whatever. That's why he couldn't empathize with her. And he also never lost the child, that idiot.
Yeah. Well, I just thought it was a bad look for him to even tell that story.
You still have the idiots that will watch him and put him on a pedestal and the content creators on here who, you know, want to tell stories. Yeah, he's still playing chess and they're all playing checkers, and that other idiot Tom LaVecchia who uses him a platform and sits and giggles and wiggles while, you know, he's bashing my father. And I emailed LaVecchia one day and I said, you know, I just saw somebody say something really, really bad about your wife. I go, how would you feel if I gave that person a platform right now to come on and say what he just said about your wife? And point well taken, he said. I said, really? Point well taken? I'll think about that going forward. Yeah, well, don't you think it's a little too late? How would you like it if I put him on and I wiggled and giggled while he said these horrible things about your wife? I just want to know.
Such a weasel.
Exactly. So as long as you have people like that, and whatever the motive was on ABC to give this person a puff piece, I don't know. But at least you had people like John Miller, who, you know, said like, yeah, he threw his family out. And what did he say? Threw his family under a bus like he did John Gotti? That's what you're dealing with. That's what you're dealing with.
Do you know your father's feelings towards John Miller? Because I know John Miller used to follow him around a lot, and sometimes he would be nice to him. Sometimes he'd be annoyed by him.
Well, because, you know, when you're walking down the street with your two friends and it's dark, and all of a sudden a car van door fly open and people jump out.
Yeah.
Now, I'm sure he didn't like him at that moment. But no, I don't know. I mean, he didn't like any of them, but he was, you know, he was polite at least sometimes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That clip where he tells John Miller to behave himself.
Exactly. He's like, I was always good to you, John. He's like, I don't like this. Something like that.
Yeah. Well, when he was coming out of the house and he said, it was a Sunday, you people belong in church.
He's like, and Giuliani should be in church.
You guys and Giuliani should be in church.
I love that. Yeah.
Yeah.
Your father never had a bad moment. Like, the camera loved him.
Yeah.
See, that was the problem, is that the camera did love him. They loved, you know, everybody's like, oh, you know, well, he was too flamboyant. But I keep asking the same question. What was he supposed to do? Go through the backyard, jump over a fence and make them meet him? You know, what did you want him to do? They were there constantly. Yeah. Where was he supposed to go? You know, he didn't tell them to come there. That was the government. The government did that. The press loved him. And it backfired on the government because the people ended up loving him.
Yeah, they thought they were going to put pressure on him.
Yeah, I think it was on Gotti, Godfather and Son, where Bruce Mao, it annoyed the crap out of him that the people loved him. Well, you shouldn't have done that then.
Yeah.
That's true. Tony Ducks just said that John said, and I forgot about this one. John said, you guys must have a lot of footage.
Yeah.
Did he?
Yeah, he said, you guys must have a lot of film.
Yeah.
Something like that.
I mean, it was all the time. All the time. Out in the, you know, like, you didn't know if you should sit outside or not. Were they going to pull up? Were they going to be, you know, parked on one of the cars that were parked there already.
Yeah.
You know, you have the kids outside playing. I mean, it was really ridiculous, but at least that's one thing they didn't do. They didn't put our kids on the papers. Yeah. They put our dog on the front page.
Well, because of who your father was, like in your late teens, early 20s, like when you would go out to restaurants, would you get like special like comps or perks and stuff like that?
No, I didn't do any like those things. You know, if I went anywhere, I didn't let people know who I was. Yeah. That's just the way that I was, you know, and nobody really recognized me. They recognized my sister, but they didn't know me. So no, and I waited online like everybody else when I wanted to get in places. I waited online, and that's the truth. Yeah. I really did. And if my friend was on here right now, she would tell you how she used to get so mad at me. Come on, tell them. Yeah. No. And I'm saying, no, I'm not telling them. And we would wait on the line like everybody else. Yeah. That's She's funny. Like, okay.
What about when you were with him, though?
Oh, yeah, forget it. It was like, you know the scene when Moses parts the sea?
Yeah.
That's how they treated him. Forget it. Yeah.
Nice.
But, you know, he was good too because he didn't want to be bothered. So, like, say the restaurant we went to all the time was Altadonna's because we loved it. So we would sit in a private area so people couldn't come over and bother us. And they even had us come in through a different entrance so that, no, you know, people didn't see us and bother, you know, bother him. and we would come in through the back and go sit down in our private, like a private area.
Nice.
And then stay there for hours and hours.
Now, you might have told me this before, Angel, but I actually asked you this in a text a few minutes before you got on the show. He had that kind of media around him before Castellano, after the Favara thing, right?
See, I never saw it. I didn't see it. I just found it the other day for the first time. You know, I always wondered when my brother said that when he was in military school and he saw my father on the news, I always wondered, like, what did he see? Because I never knew anything like that. But I just saw it the other day. And it was dated 1979. And I was like, oh, my God. And he looked so handsome. He was beautiful. His hair was jet black. He was dressed like an all black. He looked so good.
Yeah.
And so I never saw that before. You know what I mean? I never saw it until after 1985. That's when I saw things.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like. I just didn't put like him. See, when I grew up, it was the 70s, you know. Yeah. I didn't hang out with kids whose father knew him or kids that, you know, their uncles. I hung out with a totally different type of kids. They were,
from, you know, school?
They were what?
From school? Like you met these kids in school?
No. These were kids from Howard Beach, but it was a different type of crowd. You know, it was different. And that was the 70s.
Yeah.
And in the 70s, when the only gangster you ever heard of was Al Capone.
Yeah, he was the biggest at that point.
Yeah, that's all you ever heard about was Al Capone. I didn't pay attention to anything.
Yeah.
You know, we weren't into that. Like the boys that I hung out with were definitely not into any of that. Nobody knew anything.
Well, they didn't have the internet back then and all that.
You know? Exactly. Yeah. Exactly. You didn't have all of that. So I didn't know any of it. You know, it was different. Now, there's others like my sister, you know, started dating Carmine. Of course, he knew.
Yeah.
You know, but I didn't. I didn't hang out with those like anybody like that.
Yeah. Did you get along with Carmine?
Yeah, I loved him.
Yeah.
Truly, cool. Like a brother. Yeah. We got along very well.
He was another one Sammy was bashing tonight.
Really?
Was he really?
Yeah.
What was he bashing him for?
What did he say about Carmine? Well, I don't know if he was bashed. I don't remember everything. You know me. But he said something along the lines of Carmine was just, you know, his son-in-law and, you know, he basically just made him because he was trying to, you know, everybody he was talking about was family he said your father made. And it was basically to like protect himself and to build like, to get as many guys from the family made. And none of them deserved it, he said, except for Gene, your uncle Gene. He called Peter every name in the book. And he kind of made. Yeah, he kind of made fun of your brother-in-law, Carmine. Yeah.
Well, at least my father had son-in-laws.
Yeah.
Oh,
oh shit.
That almost went over my head. I'm like, wait a minute. Oh, that was a good one.
Nice.
Yeah. At least he had son-in-laws.
I could come up with... If I didn't care about your show, Gunsmoke, I could come up with so many offensive jokes right now, but I'm not going to.
Go ahead. You know I don't care.
No, I'm good.
Yeah, so whatever. Whatever. And once again, these are all men who did their time.
Exactly. These I don't know why he even bothers talking
prison.
Trash.
Yeah, they went to prison and did their time.
Yeah.
Unlike him.
Yeah, that's true. Facts.
Absolutely. Yeah, Tony Duck said, Sammy said that Carmine was a legit guy with a good business. It wasn't a guy that should be made. Yeah, he was basically saying that he talked about when the books were first opened back up and how, you know, 10 people were made from each family, this and that. But then basically once your father became boss, that he was just making whoever. And you know, he talked about a lot of the family members that were made and stuff and why. Not because they deserved it, but because they were family. And he compared your... Well, no, I was just going to say he compared your Uncle Peter to Spider from Goodfellas.
Well, I don't remember who Spider is, but I think it's so funny coming from the guy who had his wife and daughter dealing drugs with him and his son. I think that's so funny. You want to talk about my family members and what my father did. He testified that he was becoming a rat because he didn't want his son to follow him into that life. So instead, he took them to Arizona and had his two sons dealing drugs with him and his wife. And so he wants to talk about what my father did with his family members when he took his whole family into a drug ring. It's funny, right?
Yeah, I know. Well, yeah, it's like certain other podcasters will say on here that have no self-awareness. That's Sammy all of a sudden.
Exactly.
Like, I know certain things I can't make fun of because, you know, like if I'm that, you know what I mean? I'm not going to make fun of it. In other words, I'm not going to make fun of bald guys.
Exactly.
You know what I mean? Things like that. Sammy is making fun of people who are stand-up guys when he's most well known for, rightfully so, being a rat, being everything but a stand-up guy. It's unreal to me. He has no self-awareness. He doesn't sit back and think, wait a minute, what am I about to say?
He's the king rat. You know what I mean? He talks like, you know, he never ratted. It's ridiculous.
Well, maybe, I don't know. I don't even know what to say. He's a joke.
He talks like he's still underboss.
Yeah, that's right. He's a joke. If there was ever one guy who can't handle, you know, not being a part of anything anymore, it's him.
Yeah.
That's what it sounds like right now. You're talking about my family and yours was dealing drugs and all were arrested. I mean, this is amazing to me.
Yeah. He has like no shame, I guess.
Yeah. Another one, shameless. Absolutely shameless.
And he did say, I think I remember him saying on the episode, he's like, I expect them to come at me now and talk trash about me. It's all right. Something to that effect. Because he knows what he said, you know? It wasn't right.
Yeah, I want to just say this other thing to Bruno. Let me tell you something. I'm a little tired of hearing this too. Let's just say my best friend and I are hanging out. And we have another friend, which we've done this so many times. So my best friend and I are hanging out and we're upset with something that, let's just say, what's the name? I'll use Stacy, right?
Yeah.
So my best friend and I are hanging out and we're talking about things that Stacy's doing. You know, I don't understand. You know, she's doing this and she's getting it, you know, she's coming to us and we're doing, you know, we got to do this, we got to do that because Stacy's doing this and that. Where is that my father's fault? Where is that? If my best friend and I don't know that the apartment is bugged, but we're talking about what Stacy's doing, why is that my father's bringing down the whole thing?
Yeah, I know
exactly.
What? No. Have any of you sat and talked with someone, you know, your best friend about your other friend? Now, what happens if that place is bugged that you're talking about your other friend, and now your other friend finds out? How many times have we all done that?
Yeah.
I know. Every time I talk to anyone, I'm actually talking shit about Gunsmoke to them.
That's all right. I'm used to it.
I mean, I just don't understand it. It's not like they knew that the apartment was bugged. I mean, give me a break.
Of course.
And Rivano's on those tapes too. And there are tapes where my father's saying, "Jesus Christ, Sammy, you think I care about Me going to jail?
Yeah.
I'll go to jail way before you. Yep. I never let you go to jail. So everybody forgot that?
Yeah. He told Sam, he's like, I love you more than I love myself, for Christ's sake. That's, he's like, I don't give a damn about going to jail.
Right, exactly. I love you more than I love myself. Exactly.
Can't believe it, yeah.
So, you know what? I'm just so tired of hearing all of it. Mm-hmm. Whatever. You know, there's always going to be the people that believe him. And there's always going to be the people that believe this side. Yeah, and then there's
change
people, yeah, and then there's people in the middle who really just don't give a crap.
Which is a lot of people, too.
Yeah, exactly.
Hey, so, let me ask you a random question. I heard that your dad didn't like boats. Did he get angry if somebody would like drive a boat too fast if he was on it?
Down in Florida. I don't know. Florida?
Yeah, I heard a story about he was in Florida and somebody was like driving the boat too fast and he threatened them. He's like, don't you better slow down, damn it, you know? Like,
oh, I don't know if that's true. When my brother Pete is gonna come on, when he comes on, I'm gonna ask him.
Yeah,
you know, we'll ask him all those questions, but my brother, one day my father wanted to go out in the boat and there was nobody around. He told my brother Peter, come on, let's go. Yeah. Peter, I think, was 14 and Peter was driving the boat.
That's pretty cool. Wow. It's like the Sopranos episode.
Yeah. So, yeah. And there's a picture. I have a picture of it. I think I posted that picture on my Facebook page. But Peter will come on and tell.
Yeah.
And we could ask Peter that, but I don't know if that's true.
Has he been on your show yet? No, right?
No, Peter? He's going to come on.
Okay.
Yeah, he's going to come on.
That's awesome. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm looking forward to that.
Yeah, next week I am going to have Vinny Pazienza on.
Are you really?
Yes, I am. I'm so excited. Oh. What happened was, is I asked Zena, because I'm friends with Zena. She is his PR person. So I asked her, Zena, do you want to come on? Because I was really interested in speaking with her.
Yeah.
And she's like, yeah, sure, I'll come on. And maybe we can get Vinny to come on. And I was like, wow, that would be great. That would be great. So then when I... you know, we were messaging her and I, and she said, you know, Vinny's going to come on. I said, but what about you? So she's like, yeah, let's just see what happens. But Vinny's definitely coming on. I was like, yes. So
that's great.
Yeah, I have to call her. And she's going to, and Vinny's going to come on.
Awesome.
Yeah. So I'm very excited. He sent me autographed boxing gloves.
Yes, I heard you say that, Angel, and I'm going to need those.
He's one of my favorite boxers. I loved him. Vinny Pazienza
was a hell of a boxer.
Yeah, and did you see the movie Bleed for This?
No, I didn't see it.
That's his movie. Oh, it's good. It's real good.
What era in boxing is he from?
What is that, like the 90s?
Oh, the 90s?
90s, yeah, 90s.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. And he, you know, he was in a really bad car accident and broke his neck.
Oh, man.
And they didn't think he was even going to walk again, let alone box again.
Oh, man.
Yeah. And he did. He busted his rear end to get better and he ended up winning the fight.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. So I'm excited. I can't wait to have him on.
Yeah.
But like I said, I really wanted Zena. So she's like, Vinny's going to come on. I go, but can't you come on too? Like, I wanted to speak to Zena. But so let's see what happens. But I have to call her. I think I have to call her tomorrow. And then we'll have her on. Have him on.
Yeah.
Yeah, that'll be great.
You know what it is? I'm not an interviewer. So... like, I don't even know, like, what to ask him or anything. So I'm just going to say, hi, Vinny. Tell everybody everything. And hopefully he just, you know, keeps on talking because I don't know what to ask him.
You know what I do, Angel, every time? And trust me, I got a big interview coming up Tuesday I'm preparing for.
Yeah, I have to make sure that's the night that he can't come on mine. But go ahead.
Yeah, I have a limited time with this guy, most likely. So it's going to be very hard for me to ask all the questions I want. But you know what I learned with every interview? I'll have a list of questions written, usually a few pages. And what happens is it naturally, like those questions, depending on what they say, like they'll lead you into a lot of that stuff. So you don't even wind up using what you have written down. Like I'll ask, say I'll ask a guest, you know, why don't you tell us about your upbringing? And then my next question will be, how did you get involved in acting? But while they're telling me about their upbringing, they already lead into that, you know, their acting career.
Yeah,
you know what I mean?
Right,
wherever they stop, I'll just pick up from what they just said, you know, with a different question. So sometimes the best way to do it is just listen and go from there, because you'll do all this pre-planning and then realize that none of it was necessary.
No, right. Like the other night I had on this woman who, truthfully, I didn't know anything about her, nothing. And she, all I knew was that she wrote an article about my father back in 2018. And I posted, I took the article and I put it on my my Shadow of My Father Facebook page. And that's all I knew about her. So when she came on, I was floored because she went in, it went into a whole other direction where we've been saying all along how Eli hated, did nothing but rip my father and my brother apart from the time he got on to Facebook until just only what, a year ago?
Yeah. But
she was there. She wrote that article because of Eli and all his friends, you know, in this secret page that they had on Facebook. So every question that I wrote down for her, I never even got to ask her because she just took off. Like she just kept on going and going. And then it went, and I was floored. I was like, oh my God. I had no idea that she was involved in all this A-like crap from 2015.
Yeah. Wow.
So maybe, I'll just speak to Zena when I speak to her tomorrow and say, like, you know, do I have to ask him questions? But he's a motivational speaker now.
Okay.
So maybe he'll just motivate all of us.
Yeah. I'm sure he'll have a lot to talk about. Yeah.
Yeah, maybe I don't even have to ask him anything. He'll just go on and talk, you know. No, but I'll ask her tomorrow because I'm not really me. I just act like I'm sitting with you talking on the telephone.
Yeah, just hanging out. Yeah.
Just hanging out.
That's the best way to do it.
Yeah, exactly. I know Krumel likes that. Krumel keeps leaving me messages. I love this. It's like hanging out in the living room.
Well, that's what I said. With Gunsmoke's, the name of his show, we were talking about it one day and I was like, bro, I love, you know, when you just go on and talk and you get involved with the chat. I said, it's like a bunch of guys hanging out on the corner. Yeah. And that's where On the Corner with Gunsmoke the Don came from.
Exactly.
Oh, see that? That's right. That's right.
Yeah. That's right.
You know, sometimes like when you were on before FBS, right? And everybody in the chat, we were all having like a nice time. It was nice. It was a nice chat. It was really, it was interesting. The whole thing, that the show that you did. So when you were getting off, everybody's like, nah, come on, Angel. Now you have to do one. And yeah. So I said, oh crap. And then I said, all right. Cause I remembered that I had those videos. I said, oh, okay, I'll do one. And that was like not planned, not anything. And meanwhile, an hour and a half flew by.
Yeah.
You know, like I get intimidated, like, oh, what am I going to talk about? Like, what should, I can't even think of anything like right now.
That's how I feel.
Yeah. But the, you know, like the chat helps you.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. That's what I always say. Yeah. If you just start talk to the chat, yeah, it's so much better than coming on with a plan and trying to stick to it and be all organized. It goes wrong when you try too hard.
Yeah, exactly. You know, and sometimes, you know, like sometimes I'll get mad and Bad Angel comes.
Uh-uh.
Yeah, I don't like when she comes, but everybody likes her.
Yeah, it's very entertaining. Yes. People want to hear it.
Everybody else likes her.
Yeah.
So, but tonight she didn't come out at all.
Bad Angel is fun sometimes. I like when you get mad sometimes.
Yeah, everybody says that. I don't know. And then what happens is then I get into a good mood, you know, because everybody will make you laugh and stuff. And then I wake up in the morning and I'm like, oh, man, why did you do that? You know, go make it private. Take it down, you know, because I hate being – my brothers don't like Bad Angel. They like the good angel.
Well, what gets you riled up? People in the chat, like what they're saying?
Like what gets me – like when they tell me something that that other content creators say about me or my family, then all of a sudden I feel her coming. She's –
yeah, there's a lot of information that you can get from people. Roaring in the chat.
Through. Bad Angel starts roaring through.
Yeah.
But sometimes, usually I don't listen to the chat, but when I see like five people saying the same thing, then I know like that person really did say that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because you don't even watch the shows. Like, I don't watch these people's shows, but then I'll see comments in the chat, and that's where I get a lot of my information from about what's going on YouTube. I just get all the info from people in the chat, and I'm like, oh, God, you know?
Yeah, but sometimes you can't believe them because they lie.
Yeah, that's true, too. Yeah, I believe half of what I see.
Yeah, exactly. They do lie, and they like to start trouble. Yeah. So, but if you see, like, five people saying the same thing, and like somebody like Miss Can't Be Wrong or Carlos, then you know that it's true.
Exactly. Yeah.
You know? So then all of a sudden Bad Angel starts coming out.
Yeah.
But
when I get upset, I don't even go live. So that's pretty cool that you go live and you don't care, you know, it's just like whatever.
Yeah. No, because then I won't sleep all night.
Yeah.
Because then I get it out. Turn, yeah. And then I stop banging dishes and this.
Oh, no.
Yeah. So I have to get it out.
Okay.
But I'm starting to I don't watch any of the shows anymore.
Yeah.
But sometimes I'll see something and I'm like, all right, let me go check this out. And now, no. Now I won't watch.
Yeah,
now,
like, are you even interested in like the mob genre at all?
Not at all. I can't. Yeah. I have zero interest in it. What, like zero?
Yeah.
You know, like and like say with FBS and MRE, you know, like or who's the other one? Gunsmoke. You, I watch sometimes, but you curse too much.
I know, and I smoke too much. Yeah. No, I hear you. I don't blame you.
One day, Gunsmoke, you had on a show that I says, let me put it on. Because I like to listen to something while I'm cleaning and I'm cooking and doing you know, stuff like that. See, the TV, then I'd have to go watch it. But with this, at least I could put it on and I can go do what I have to do. And I listen to you. And one day you were on and it was like so in, like I was really into it. I said, he's got a nice voice, you know, like he sounds good.
Thank you.
And I even commented to you, like, I'm here, Gunsmoke.
Yeah.
But then sometimes you curse a lot.
I do, yeah. I have a weird sense of humor. And, I don't know. It feels good to curse sometimes. I don't know.
No, and then sometimes, you know, you have other people on and I'm like, you know, this is a young conversation. You know, this is young. Like my son would get a kick out of you.
Yeah. But, you know, I try to appeal. I have an old soul, too, though. I try to appeal to the older folks.
No, I know. I love your voice. See, I love your voice.
I have a nasally voice because I got into a fist fight at 16 and I got hit in the nose and I never went to go get it checked out. So I sound nasally. I hate my voice.
No, I think you have. I think you sound great. I even told Jerry.
Thank you. I told
Jerry that. I said, he has such a nice voice. Like, I like listening to him.
Yeah.
But he's talking about things like for a younger crowd, and he curses a lot.
Yeah. Not how great is Jerry, though?
I'm going to have virgin ears. I don't mean it that way. I mean, like, you're talking to a younger crowd. That's what I mean.
Yeah, I should definitely tone it down with the cursing, I know, so I could appeal to more people. Because I know it's not good. I know it's not a good look. It looks trashy. It's like a
30-something and below crowd.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. I should clean it up. I got to grow up. How great is Jerry, though? I love Jerry. Jerry's the best.
Jerry is the best. I can't tell you how I torture him. I really do. I sent him like 10 things. I'm like, you know, but the other things, I'm just showing you them. I just want you to see these.
And he does great work for you.
Yeah, and meanwhile, he does it for me. Yeah. I don't even know how to do anything. I don't know how to fit the pictures into the thumbnail.
Yeah.
So he sizes it for me so that I could just take it and put it right in there.
Yeah. Yeah, he's helped me a lot, too, with my channel and stuff. So
yeah.
He's an awesome guy.
FBS, did you take a nap that you keep yawning?
I don't know what's wrong with me. Ever since I've been sick, like, I don't know, this ear infection, whatever. I'm exhausted. Like, only the last few days, and today is the first day where I didn't. So I'm just exhausted. I don't know why.
Yeah, but did
it's
you?
So strange.
Did you look up what ear infections do? Like, even too much wax in your ear, what that causes?
That causes
headaches.
Yeah.
Depression. Yeah. You become very lethargic.
Yeah.
There's a whole bunch of things that I never knew that
I got all those.
Even just too much wax in your ear causes that. I never knew that.
It's no
memory loss. You better go.
Oh, Jesus.
He definitely has that. Me too.
You better go get your ears checked.
Chris Childers said ED.
Oh, yeah, take yourself to the ED.
No, I'm not having that's one issue. I'm not having, thank God.
It causes a lot of vertigo, exactly. It does, it causes vertigo. A lot, and I never knew that just having even too much wax in your ear. So, if you have fluid in your ear, you really need to go check that out.
I never knew what
I
gotta
go to the doctor this week coming up.
Yeah, you really should know.
I never knew what vertigo was until that actress died a few years ago on that boat. What was her name? Nadia or Naya Rivera, whatever.
Oh,
she was on
a
boat swimming.
Right.
She had vertigo.
Right. That's
I was like, what the hell is vertigo? So I looked it up and I was like, oh my God.
That's when you feel like you're walking sideways.
Yeah.
Right?
I had that. I got that right around my birthday of last year. I just woke up one day and I stood up and I just fell right over. Like, I was so dizzy. And I went to the doctor and they gave me Meclizine, I think, to take the dizziness away. But they had no idea what brought it on. It lasted about 3 days and then it just went away. It's so strange.
Wow.
It's bad. I mean, it's not just being dizzy. I mean, it's like... No. Picture you being at your drunkest.
Like the room is moving.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's really bad.
Everything around you is spinning.
I had it once when I was driving. Yeah.
So you just go get your ears checked. You can even go to a regular doctor and get your ears checked. If you can't get an appointment with the ENT. But I would just go get your ears checked.
Yeah, you definitely need to. Yeah. It's been a while. Yeah.
What time are you going on, FBS?
I don't know. I guess whenever Gunsmoke's done, I'll go on.
Yeah,
I'll
shut it down soon.
I'm getting off now anyway.
I want to talk a little bit about this Sammy nonsense. So.
Okay, very good.
Angel, thank you so much for coming on my show. I really appreciate it. I'm so honored.
You, no problem.
You are the best. Thank you so much. I love you. I love your family. I am honored to have you here. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. All right. So I'll see everybody over at FBS.
Yes, definitely.
Right. I didn't even do my dish.
All right. Thank you.
All right. Bye. Thank you, guys. Bye.
Good night. Bye. Good night.
Yep. Talk to you soon. Bye.
Well, that was awesome. Yeah, that was a pleasant surprise. I wasn't expecting that at all. That's awesome. I got to retitle the show now and everything. That was great.
Yeah, you have to. And you were asking me why I'm looking down. See, I'm trying to help you out.
Yeah, I was like, what the hell is he doing over there? That was great.
Well, I made a community post too, and I told everybody to come over here.
Oh, you did? That's why I have so many people watching me right now.
I don't know, but I said, not long a lot after for me. You won, while you were playing your video, I did that.
Nice.
Before I came on, I did a community thing. So
you're the best.
You got 53, you, not bad.
Yeah, that's good for me. Man. Thank you so much, bro. You're the best. Yeah. So whenever you want to get the hell out of here, we'll go over to your show. That's how we do on MobTube. We just hop from one show to another.
Absolutely. Watching
Angels and every. Yeah. Go on.
I'm sorry. Everybody who isn't subscribed to Gunsmoke, please subscribe now. Hit your notification bell. And, you know, if you got it, throw him a few dollars, you know?
Oh, yeah.
Gunsmoke's working hard. He busted his ass on that video. I know he was working on that shit for a couple of days.
So, yeah, I was. Yeah, a couple of days. Yeah.
Yeah, show him your support if you can and get used to it, because I'm going to make sure that Gunsmoke stays motivated and is on here more often.
Yeah, I was like, damn, while we were talking to Angel, I'm like, look, I didn't even plan to come on tonight. I wasn't going to go on tonight. And I was like, look, now I'm here talking to Angel Gotti out of nowhere. Like, that's crazy. So that was awesome.
Bro, that's why, like I say, man, every time I feel like not doing a show, it makes me want to do a show more, because it's times like that when good shit happens.
Yeah.
Like, you'll go on and think, I don't even have anything to talk about. And then you get a good guest or a good subject pops up and it winds up being a good show.
Yeah, it was just a great subject, man. I'm glad we had that conversation about it, because it just blew my mind. I never even thought about it. I'm like, yo, that would be a great conversation, man. You're right.
Yeah, yeah. So, yeah, and it was.
Yeah.
All right, I'm going to get going. I'm going to go do a couple things, and I'm going to pop on for a little bit. So yeah. It's up to you, man. If you're free, you can pop on with me.
All right. Yeah. I'll definitely be there. You know I'll be there.
All right. Oh, there you go.
Oh, wow. Look at that. Angel kicking up. Look at this. Thank you, Angel. $20. Beautiful. Thank you so much, Angel. You're a sweetheart. I really appreciate that. Thank you.
That's very nice of Angel.
Yeah.
All right, bro. I'll see you in a little bit.
All right, bro. All right.
All right. Peace.
Later. So that was the King of Mob Tube, guys. FBS. And I had Angel Gotti on tonight. That was awesome. Thank you, Angel, again for stopping by and for the super chat. Thank you. Super sticker. Yeah, we're going to all head over to FBS's channel now in a few minutes. That's going to be fun, as always, and entertaining. And I don't know. I'm just very happy with the show tonight. I want to thank you all for tuning in and watching. I don't even know what to say anymore. You guys are awesome, man. It's been a while since I've been on MobTube, so to come back and have a show like this tonight was awesome. And for all you guys to be watching, I just really appreciate it, man. And I'm going to be doing more live shows coming up. I'm going to try to be more consistent again like I was for a while. So, yeah, I'm back in full effect. I'm going to be trying to work on more videos too. So look out for that. And you guys have a good night. Stay safe out there. Have a good weekend. I love you guys. Peace.